Congratulations, you get to make a new best friend. Oh, how fun is that?
Dylan, what are you talking about?
The college interview, of course. Listen up, guys, the college interview is not just a person asking you a bunch of questions to determine your self-worth. No. It's a conversation, it's a dialogue, it's fun, it's casual. In this video, I'm gonna teach you guys a ton of tips on how to nail that college interview. I'm gonna cover how it works, what they're looking for, the prep that you should do before going into the interview, some personal experience from my interview with Stanford, how to act, how to hold yourself, actually not act, how to be. You're not acting, you're being. I'm also gonna cover how you should ask the interviewer questions and what questions to ask them, what to do the day of in terms of preparing your technology, how you should follow up after your interview, and some tips on some schools like U of Chicago, for example, that may have an optional video interview submission component. All right, let us jump into it. First of all, what's an interview? How does it work? After you have submitted your whole application, your essays, activities, yada yada, you might be contacted via email about scheduling an interview date. Now, not every school does this, and it is so important to look at your school's interview policies. Are they holding interviews for everyone? Is it just people in a certain area? Is it just for people doing a certain scholarship? Make sure that you do all the research on the schools that you're applying to so you are well prepared. Now, usually the interviewer is going to be an alumnus of the school, someone who went there, graduated from that school, and are now living their lives as adults. The whole point of the interview is to get to know who you are. They are perceiving you, experiencing you in this moment, rather than just how you look on paper. Interviews tend to be optional, and if you have the opportunity to do an interview, I highly recommend doing so. That way you're seen as an actual person, not just numbers and words from your application. So most of the time, although I would check the requirements for your specific schools, the interviewer is not gonna know anything about you. They're not gonna have read your application, they don't know what clubs you're involved in, they don't know your essays, any of that. They are just meeting another person. So the whole point for them is to get to know your vibe. They're looking for an inquisitive mind, someone who wants to make the best out of their college experience, someone who can reflect on their own values and understand how they address certain problems. Kind of throughout the whole application process, the emphasis is really on intellectual vitality and emotional intelligence, and I do have videos on both of those. The interviewer will be taking notes during your interview, but don't worry about it, just be yourself. And then they'll send a report back to the school based on how they see you will fit in with their school. All right, let's talk about prep. How are you gonna make sure that you're gonna be able to answer the questions when given to you and not just sit there going, you don't wanna do that, I get it. Here is how you prep. First, I'm gonna go over some general stuff, then we're gonna get into the specifics. Refresh yourself on the whole application. If it's been a couple weeks, couple months, you kinda need to go back and read all of your essays, all of your extracurriculars, just refresh your memory of everything that's on your application, because you might need to immediately speak on those things. Research the college. They're probably gonna ask you some things about why you wanna go there. So you need to have very specific reasons that you can easily say off the top of your mind. Just like the Why Us essays, you know, you gotta do your research into the programs, the clubs, the vibe of the school, their mission, their ideals, their traditions, their fun events, their student life. All of those things you wanna be super sharp on. I also recommend jotting down a bunch of facts about yourself. This is kind of like what you might have done when brainstorming for your college essays. Who are you? What are your core values? What are some impactful experiences in your life? Who are your role models? And I kind of already got into it, but you need to bullet point your answers for all the common interview questions. So, what are the common college interview questions? Here we go. Oh, the classic. Tell me about yourself. For this question, it's more about your qualities and values as a person rather than your activities and all the things that you do. Why do you want to go to this college? I already mentioned this one. Be specific and show your interest. Your biggest challenge or failure or obstacle. Keep in mind the challenge itself isn't as important as how you addressed it, your mindset or attitude about it, and the result. What are your strengths and weaknesses? What do you see yourself doing in 10 years from now? Describe a time where you showed leadership. What is your greatest accomplishment? What is your favorite subject in school? Who are your role models? If you could teach a class to your high school, what would it be? How would your best friend describe you? If you had $1 million, how would you spend it? Now, these aren't the only questions that they will ask you. There might be some wacky curveball questions that they might throw at you. And that's okay. If you jot down a bunch of different ideas and things that you're having, it might be easier for you to come up with an answer in that instant. it's a really good idea to include stories that aren't already mentioned on your application. This gives you a chance to show a new side of you, to complete that whole picture. And I'm gonna give a quick example from my Stanford interview that really benefited me in the end because I read my interviewer's note in my admissions file after I got in. So with that question of how have you shown leadership? I talked about a story that wasn't mentioned at all on my application. I had led a group to create an 8-minute version of the musical Bring It On, which we performed with only 4 chairs, which we choreographed, directed, sang a cappella, all by ourselves without the help of any teachers. And then we performed it at a drama festival called D-Task. This was an important story for me to tell to the interviewer because I went under a lot of personal growth during that experience. I ended up having to carry a lot of the weight of the group, and I was constantly frustrated by my groupmates not being focused or fooling around. So I almost had to be the bad guy in a sense, and I had to yell at them to stay focused. I had to organize all the schedules. I had to get everything together to make sure that we were ready by the day of the competition. And I did end up lashing out, and I yelled at a girl and I made her cry, and I told my interviewer that. I was always known to be the person who never wanted to cause any conflict. I wanted everyone to be happy, positive all the time, but I couldn't be that person in this situation. And that made me think a lot about my own identity. It thickened my shell and I became a stronger person. So I told all of this to my interviewer, and he actually ended up writing about a lot of it in his write-up to Stanford. So the story that wasn't even on my application still made a difference. Now, the thing about prepping for an interview is that you are not making a script. You do not want to write out your words line for line, then memorize it, then perform it for the interviewer. The interview is a conversation, and I'm probably going to keep saying that. Just like in all conversations, it flows naturally. One thing leads to another, so you're not going to be able to strictly follow a script that you make for yourself. You need to talk naturally. So this is already leading me into a good segue for how to be. Don't act, just be. What do I mean by don't act? Don't say what you think they want you to say. It's not about answering the question in the correct way, because there is no correct way. It is about you being genuine and honest. So answer every question honestly. Even if you don't know the answer to the question, be honest. Just be like, I actually am not really sure about that, but, and then add a different point. Rather than going, I'm not really sure about that, sorry. It's okay if you don't know, just stay confident and be honest. Along with being honest, be yourself. If you tend to be a very humorous person, go ahead, throw in some jokes, be playful. Obviously, read the room so you know if you're overstepping your boundaries. But you can be relaxed, it is a conversation, after all. It's also fun if you can find commonalities between you and your interviewer. I had a friend whose interviewer grew up in the same city as them. So they were like, for example, oh my God, you're from that one city too? Oh my gosh, do you know that one mainstream coffee shop? Yeah, I love it. I get this all the time. Blah, 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 blah. It's fun. It's friendly. They are your friend. Honestly, that's the mindset I went into my interview with. As in, I'm going to make a friend today. I'm going to get on a talk with someone. I'm going to learn about them. I'm going to talk about myself. And it's going to be a great time. There's not going to be any stress about them evaluating me or if I answered the question correctly, because the interview isn't all about that. It's about being genuine. Now, the college interview is a two-way street. It's not just you telling them everything about you. You actually get to listen to what they have to say as well. This is also a wonderful opportunity for you to learn more about the college through a person who actually went there. So listen to them, show interest in what they're saying, ask follow-up questions. Because more than likely, after you share your response, they're gonna share their response back, their own perspectives and experiences that relate to what you just said. The conversation will flow naturally, and the interviewer does not have to ask every single question that is on their sheet. And usually towards the end, maybe the last 10 minutes, the interviewer might ask you, is there anything you wanna ask me? And in that moment, you must say yes. Have questions prepared to ask them. This also goes into the prep. You want to spark their own nostalgia from when they went to that school. Ask about the dorm life, the food, their traditions, maybe their favorite memory, their favorite class that they took that changed their life. Maybe ask about their opinion or stance on something that you've heard about the school but you aren't sure is necessarily true. Maybe you want to ask them what they would change about the college if they could. Maybe you want to ask about how the college handles certain issues like emergencies, social justice issues, mental health, etc. So, the day of, what should you be doing? Get up early, eat your breakfast, Do a tech check. If your interview is going to be on Zoom or Google Hangouts or FaceTime, you must check your Wi-Fi, check your audio, check your video all before the interview. Close other applications and tabs so it doesn't wear down your computer. And in terms of presentation, you want to dress nicely. It doesn't have to be too professional or businessy or anything, but I would just say nice and casual. Have nice lighting, be facing the light so there's a window or a lamp in front of you. Don't be backlit, don't have a light coming from the back because they won't be able to see your face. Pay attention to your background. I'm not gonna say make it a whole plain background because I understand that you might wanna have some things in the background that show a little bit of your personality, but you do wanna make sure that you don't have family members walking across, dogs running across. I always have dogs running across my screen. Before your interview, shake out your nerves. You don't wanna be stiff. I'm talking get up and just, you know? Shake it out and take deep breaths if you are feeling nervous. Have a glass of water next to you, go to the bathroom before you log on, and when you log on, make sure you're early. Alrighty, so after you have had your lovely conversation, you've made a new friend, congratulations, you have finished your college interview, but don't just leave it at that. Once you have logged off, you want to send them a thank you email. A thank you email or letter after you finish your college interview will help you be more rememberable. Rememberable is not a word, okay. Memorable. Something like, thank you so much for taking the time to meet with me today. I had a wonderful time talking about blah, 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 blah. Mention specific details from the interview and what you learned from them, gained from them, or how you felt about them. So that will help them jog their memory of who you are because they do a lot of interviews with a lot of different students. And that thank you email is one little sweet extra touch. One more thing before we log off here, I wanna talk about submitting a video interview. This is different than an actual face-to-face interview like I've been talking about, but for colleges like Columbia or U of Chicago, which have an optional video interview submission. Now, this little piece of advice is from a friend who is a college consultant at Prep Scholar, and she gave me some wonderful tips to share with you guys right now. Columbia's video interview can be more intellectual, but they do appreciate the artistic nature of an interesting video. But for U of Chicago's video, you can go all out, go wacky. You want to be interesting, unique, and creative. You can even do a music video if you wanted. Record all of your answers in one video and have fun with the editing. Make it fun and engaging and as unique as possible. The whole point here is to stand out and show your personality. Because they don't want to see students who are just droning on, talking and talking and talking. That's it for today's video. If you found it helpful, please give it a like and subscribe because I am posting college application videos all the time. And you can share this video with your friends as well to help them out. I would greatly appreciate it. Alrighty right, that's it for today. Hope you have a wonderful day. Good luck on your interviews. Bye-bye.